the teachers, my seniors and my friends present here. First of all, I would like to thank my teacher for giving me this golden opportunity to present my presentation. So my presentation topic is on that topic which we see in our day-to-day life, but we never wanted to know more about it. I am talking about bryophytes. Let's see what bryophytes are. So the term bryophyta originates from the word bryon, which means mosses, and phyton, which means plant. The bryophyta includes endophytes like mosses, hornbirds, and riverbirds. They are small plants that grow in moist and shady places. They lack vascular tissue, that means they do not have xylem as well. They don't produce flowers and seeds like other plants. The bryophyta are also known as amphibians of the plant kingdom, as they are terrestrial and grow in moist and shady places. The study of bryophyte is called bryology. Let's see what are the criteria for their classification. Following characters are used for their classification. They are structure of thallus, anatomy of the thallus, types of rhizoids, types of scales, positions of sex organs, structure of sporophyte, and nature of sporophyte. We can see from the slide also the different types of bryophytes. Here we can see the photograph of liverwort and the spot moss. Most accepted classification. Modern biologists have classified bryophytes of antiprotozoa are Humeria, Sphagnum, and Polyphrygian. And if we talk about Bryopsida, it is also known as moss. And the most reliable example of Bryopsida is Neurothallus. Vegetative propagation in bryophytes. Most of the bryophytes propagate vegetatively. The vegetative reproduction takes place in favorable conditions for the of the plant. So this is the most common method of vegetative propagation in bryophytes. When the progressive death and decay reach to the dichotomy of the plant, then two branches are formed. These two branches may develop into a new thallus. Now we can see from the photograph also this process. The second method is the adventitious branches. The adventitious branches grow from the ventral surface of the thallus and then get separated from the parent thallus and then develop into a new thallus. Example of adventitious branches are Rickettsia, Pilea, etc. The third method is by gamma. So basically, gamma is green, bilob, multicellular, single stalk structure which plays the main role in the vegetative propagation in bryophytes. We can see from the diagram also, this is the gamma curve, and there are so many gamma in the single gamma curve. This is the detailed structure of a mature gamma. We can see here when the gamma matures, it gets detached from its stalk and splits vertically into two halves, and both these fragments may develop into a new thallus. Each gamma produces two new thallus. These are the some other methods of vegetative propagation in bryophytes. They are by tubers, by primary protonema, and by secondary protonema. If we talk about sexual reproduction in bryophytes, the sexual reproduction is highly gametic. And male and female sex organs are known as archegonia and antheria. Sex organs are gelatin and multicellular, and water is essential for their fertilization. Without water, there is no fertilization. Importance of bryophytes. Bryophytes have great ecological and economical importance. We use bryophytes in medicinal use. So, sphagnum, which is a bryophyte, is used in surgical dressing due to its high absorptive power and some antiseptic properties. Marquesia has been used to cure pulmonary tuberculosis and affection of liver. Polyphrygian species has been shown to dissolve stones in kidneys and gallbladder. We use bryophyte in experimental botany also. The liverworts and mosses play the main role, important role as a research tool in various fields of botany such as genetics. Indicator of soil pH. Liverworts and mosses are great are indicators of soil pH. Some bryophytes can grow in narrow and specific range of pH, so their presence can be used as an indicator of soil pH. For packing use, we use bryophytes in packing material also. Dry mosses and bryophytes have great ability to hold water. They have great ability to hold water, that's why bryophytes are used as packing materials for flowers, fruits, vegetables, tubers, etc. Thank you so much for giving me your attention.